Hello, today I am going to show you how you can do database connectivity using PHP MySQL. So first of all, you need XAMPP, you need this. Now I am going to show you from where you can download this XAMPP. So first of all, open Google. Now right over here, download XAMPP. Now you can download XAMPP from here. You can download this XAMPP here. After downloading this, you have to set up this XAMPP, so you will get this type of icon on desktop. Now double click on this XAMPP and start this both service, Apache service and MySQL service. Apache service is useful for run PHP code, and MySQL service is useful for run MySQL code, means one type of to create database. Now after start these both services, you have to open your browser and you have to write here localhost/phpmyadmin. When you write this, you get MySQL stream. This is the MySQL stream. Now from here you can create one database. I am going to create here database. Name is testing. Oh, I have already this testing database, so I have to here testing underscore new. Now create. So your database is created now. Testing underscore new and enter get 0 means there is no available table in this database. So I have to create one table. I'm going to here pass the table name table 1 and going to pass here number of field 2. Then press go. So they ask you about field name, so I am going to here name and city, both are work here, and passed here length. This is the length, means how many number of characters name do you want to use length. Now press save. Now you can see here, here you are getting this table 1. When I click on this browse button, you can see here I get here close sign, means there is no available record in this table. If you want to add record from here, then you have to click here insert, then you have to write here name and city, then press go. Now you are going to get here your record, but I show you, you can do this using MySQL, but we have to do this using PHP and MySQL. So first of all, I am going to empty this table. You can see here now again I get cross sign, there is no available record in this table. So now I am going to open Dreamweaver. Or you can use Notepad also, but Dreamweaver is good for PHP. Now take here create new PHP file. And yes, most important, I have to save this file, but consider you have to save this file inside your XAMPP. So you have to remember when you install in the XAMPP where you install your XAMPP. Now I install my XAMPP in E drive. So E drive in XAMPP. And inside this XAMPP folder, I have another folder htdocs. This is the virtual directory, so I have to save my program over here. Now I am saving here testing db.php. Now I am going to run this localhost. testing db.php. You can see here I am getting here. But right now there is nothing in my PHP file, so I am getting blank file. Now I have to take here two textbots. So I am going to take here first table. Sorry, this is a spelling mistake. Table. Then I have to take here tr. Then I have to take here td. enter name, then I have to take here another td, input type text, I have to pass here name t1. Now I copy this row, paste here, enter ct, and pass here t2. Now again I am going to take one tr td, and here I am going to use call span because I want this button in center. Input type submit, name submit 1, and value store record. Now I have to pass here a line center, and the most important, we have to take one form tag. Without form tag you cannot do this, so I am going to take here form tag, then I take here method, and now I close form tag over here. Now you can see I get here two text box and one submit button. Now I have to create one event, like click event in PHP. So I take here if is set underscore post and submit 1. This is the name of button. Now here I have to do database connect. So first of all I have to write MySQL connect, and here I have to pass 3 parameter. One is, first one is server name, this by default localhost. Second one is username, this is by default root. And third one is password, password is blank. This is the by default, but you can change. MySQL select db, and here we have to pass our db name. So check here our db name. Our db name is testing underscore new. So I pass here testing underscore new. Then I have to write query. Insert into, here we have to pass our table name, table 1 values, and here we have to pass our two parameter, one is for name, one is for city. So I am going to pass here underscore post t1 and dollar underscore post t2. Now we can check here name noble imported, and city is Rajkot, and I am going to here store. Now you can see here I am getting here this record. I am going to pass here another record, Amit, and city is Baroda, and press store button. Now we can see here we get here second record. So this way you can do PHP MySQL database connectivity. Thank you.